then 1, 2, 3, start rolling. Half a second later, break 4 and 5. And 1.5 seconds after everybody, we see the 6, 7, 8 and 9. Just rolling out now, start the display, ladies and gentlemen. Please get your cameras ready. We're going to have lots of fabulous, patriotic red, white and green. Starting cool, ladies and gentlemen. It's the Royal Air Force Aerobatic Team 2015. It's the winner! his career as an instructor on the Sparrow aircraft, he was a faster training. In fact, he also displayed the Sparrow as it went down. Instead, he's been joined with the Royal Air Force Typhoon, the newest fighter in our fleet. With his role, exactly what I've just been talking about, primary role of the Typhoon Force. Secure the sky. The forces are at readiness 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. That's exactly what Tom was doing on quickly after the Typhoon Force. Tom would like to say hello today to his mum and dad, seeing him display for the first time. Well, hello to David and Jackie. In from the right now, slightly wider diamond. This is the new maneuver for 2015, and this is the whirlwind. Gippo was nicknamed the gentleman who first led the back four aircraft when the Renault started the Christie Flight 90 display back in 1968. The Jag is about to roll out directly towards us. It's definitely time to get your cameras ready. They're bringing it round at around 3G to point directly here at the airfield. You'll soon see those nose light points straight towards you. Cameras ready to start the second half of the display. Smoke comes on as we get ready for the detonator. Phoenix flick at the top. Now keep your eyes on Gippo underneath.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the last minute.
Located in the center of the formation with three aircraft on site. Highlight the great coordination and accuracy of the pilot. The second part, much more dynamic, the formation break in three groups. The solo, the third. Coming forward. In the blue food formation, in the 4 or 5 flight inverted from the bigger 2.7.
Thank you.
120 knots up to 600 knots. Really spectacular. This plane is plenty of changes to pace, and there we see one of them out of that load of barrel rolls. He's now repositioning for a classic, pardon me, any F-16 plane, high alpha or high angle attack path. Yeah, this is really spectacular, especially at the moment into a 15 knot headwind. His ground speed will be somewhere in the region of 95 knots, or around about 100 miles an hour, which, if you contrast that with a Cessna 152, that's the same cruising speed. Right, when we talk about alpha and angle attack, what is it exactly that we mean? That's the angle of attack that the air is going over the wind. Kawasaki, 2-1.